This video is all about productivity apps to enhance your 2022. Like always, links to everything will be in the description below, and my thanks to Spike for sponsoring this video. Speaking of Spike, that is the first app we're going to cover here. That is a conversational email app with excellent group collaboration features. What I like about this is it takes the formality of email out of the equation. I like this because it clears the clutter of the traditional email out of my inbox, but I know the person on the other end is still receiving a regular email. When writing a message, you can easily attach images, files, and GIFs like you would come to expect from any email application. One of my favorite email features that's in Spike is the ability to hide messages until some point in the future. Now, I get a lot of emails about things that I can't necessarily deal with in the moment, whether I'm waiting for another part to come in, or I'm waiting on a contract, or whatever. I'm waiting on something, so I can't deal with this email at that particular moment. With Spike, you can send that email off into the future and it'll come back to your inbox at that set point. Spike's inbox also has some smarts behind it as well. So I have this set up to filter when new emails come in. If it's somebody in my contacts or somebody I've messaged in the past, it goes right into the inbox. But if it's a cold email, a newsletter, something I just didn't sign up for, it goes into an other folder. And then I can just deal with that stuff whenever I have time. In the inbox, you can also create notes and tasks. This is great if something comes in and you want to write a little reminder to yourself about it in the future. It sits in your inbox and then you can see that reminder, and when you have a chance or when it comes time to deal with that, you'll see it, be reminded about it, and you can deal with it. But there's also a collaborative aspect to these notes and tasks. So anyone else that's using Spike, you can share them with them and you can work on these reminders and tasks together. So if you're working on a project and you have a bunch of steps that need to get done, you can work on these and see what's getting done by the other person and they can see what's getting done by you. In addition to notes and reminders, there is also a calendar view so you can see all of your appointments right from Spike. There's even built-in video and voice chat in Spike. It's just an all-around great collaborative tool. Spike works across all the platforms, iOS, Mac, Android, and even the web. I will put a link in the description below to where you can check out Spike. And again, my thanks to Spike for sponsoring this video. Keepit is a note-taking app, but also a database app. It kind of blends together in a really nice fashion. I've been using this to store apps and tips and tricks I want to cover. This stuff can clog up my traditional note-taking app really quickly. Keepit has an excellent tagging system so you can organize all your content. And then there's excellent search as well. As a database app, it does a great job of linking to different kinds of content. If you're linking to something that's just a web page, it'll even load the page right in the app. Now, you absolutely could use Keepit as just a note-taking app, but I feel its real power is when it becomes kind of a database for like storing stuff for a long period of time, but then you can also write notes about that. It's just a good tool for this kind of thing. Noteplan is a more traditional note-taking app, but with a small spin on it. Its main focus is on daily notes. It links up with your calendar and the Reminders app, and you can write all of your notes for the day in one place. Now, my brain just doesn't work this way. I tried to use it, and I was just like, okay, I can't write all of my video projects and my personal stuff in one place for one day. I couldn't just wrap my head around that. But if you want more traditional file and folder note taking, that is in there as well. Even if you do want to use the daily notes, this is great for categorizing stuff for long periods of time. In Noteplan, you can pull down on the note to make a quick reminder or calendar event. This is super cool. I love how integrated notes and calendars and reminders are in this app. Honestly, this is how Apple's suite of, you know, calendars, reminders, and notes should be. Noteplan also has wiki-style linking and mention support. This is great for linking all of your notes and content together, so that way you can quickly reference stuff and jump through two different notes in the application. But there's one big feature that just keeps me from using it, and it's a small thing too, because I absolutely could swap it out. But if it sees an asterisk, it turns that into a to-do. And I use asterisk as bulleted lists for when I'm writing out outlines and scripts. I break all my stuff up that way. So it turns all that stuff into to-dos, and I don't like that. Now, you could just use a dash instead. That would be fine. but I like asterisks. There's a ton you can do with Noteplan. I should probably do a dedicated video on it. In fact, any app in this video, if you'd like to see a dedicated video, let me know in the comments below. Due is a timer app meets reminders app. What's cool about this is you can set up reminders in the app and then it'll nag you until you get them done. It's really great for super time sensitive tasks, things that have to be done that could be personally world ending to you. So something I do is I have it set up for 2 times a day to remind me to take my meds. These are on repeating reminders at 6 a.m. and 6 p.m. and they just go off and they will keep reminding me about them until I get them done. You can set up repeating tasks and you can change how often it does the reminders. Personally, I like every 10 minutes. It's just kind of enough time period for a reminder to go off, give me enough time to do something, and then I can mark it complete before the second reminder or the third reminder or whatever goes off. It also has excellent shortcuts integration if you're looking for something that you could just like fire off a shortcut and then start a series of timers. Trello is a collaborative Kanban system. Kanban basically works with a group of tasks that you can move through different stages. With Trello, you can work with a group of people and assign tasks to certain people, then move the tasks through different stages. Trello is great for any group projects and tracking large amount of tasks within a project. It's also web-based, so it'll work on any platform. So no matter what platform your group is using, guaranteed you can use Trello. Tasks is a task management app that I really like and I've talked about before, but it recently got a big update. Like Trello, it uses a Kanban system, but you can also turn those projects into a simple list. It recently got updated to support folders and smart list, and it's on its way to being a true professional task management app. Right now I've got a lot going on, so I can't swap out my task manager, but I've been playing with this one a lot and it has me super intrigued that when I get a chance, I may make this my main task manager. I need to play with it a little more. But I wanted to talk about it because if you're looking for a native app for the Apple ecosystem that does both Kanban and list views, Tasks is a good app to start looking at for that. Goodnotes is probably the most popular app on the iPad. Anytime somebody makes an iPad apps video on YouTube, there's a really good chance Goodnotes is gonna be on that list. It's a digital notebook app with a ton of different paper style templates. So you can swap all the templates out for normal lined paper or the squared paper or all sorts of stuff that I've never even heard of. It's a really good app for that. It's also got a great ink engine. So when you're using the Apple Pencil, like it just looks really nice. Like some of the stuff people can do in Goodnotes, I can't do it, but some of the stuff people could do in Goodnotes is really impressive. So if you're looking to turn your iPad into a digital notebook, I think Goodnotes is the best place to start. Concepts is another iPad app. This one is for drawing, but what's different about this as opposed to other drawing apps is it has an infinite canvas. Basically what that means is you can zoom out and move around and it just keeps making the image larger and larger so you don't run up against edges. Now, I can't draw to save my life, but what I like using Concepts for is planning out a large project or mapping something out. So I can just kind of like start writing things out and I can zoom out more, I can keep zooming out and keep moving around, and I don't ever run into an edge. I don't ever have to go to a second page or anything like that. This is where the power of the iPad over something like a physical notebook comes into play. Also, Concepts has really great tools for drawing or handwriting, and out of all of the iPad apps, it has one of my favorite color pickers. So a quick tip, when using the Apple Pencil a lot, I like to use a Paperlike. Paperlike, full disclosure, is a channel sponsor, but what I like about it is it's a textured screen protector. So when you're using the Apple Pencil and you're writing on the iPad, it feels like you're using a pencil and paper as opposed to plastic on glass. I really don't like that plastic on glass feeling, so I will always recommend the Paperlike. I really, really like it. Okay, so this next one is more of a tip, not really an app, because it uses the Files app. It's built into iPadOS and iOS, but there is a scanner built right into the Files app. So if you're still getting physical documents, you can go into the Files app, hit the More button, select Scan Document, then you just line up the camera with the document. It will detect the page and then auto crop to fit that, and then just scan the document. And then you can add more pages or you can save the file, whatever you need to do. It's a really great built-in utility. So that's it for this video. Let me know what your favorite productivity app is in the comments below. My thanks to Spike for sponsoring this video. Hit the thumbs up button if you liked the video. Subscribe if you haven't already. Thank you for watching and have a great day.